welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time watching one of my videos, welcome. So great to have you here. If this is not your first time and you're actually a subscriber, hey, welcome. So today, as you can see, I am barefaced. I'm literally in my robe. I got my durag on. I am getting ready to go and hang out with friends in the city. So I thought, why not make a little get ready with me type video slash mini tutorial. I want to show you guys how I do like my everyday dewy sort of glowy makeup look. When I wear makeup, I wear it to enhance certain like features, certain like facial features, and my goal when wearing makeup is to just bring out my skin and make it pop. So I do that with a lot of shimmer, but not too much, but just the right amount. So I thought, why not show you guys how I achieve that look. So I'm just gonna get into it. This is gonna be like my first type of beauty video, so like I don't really know how this is gonna work, but we'll try. So I actually have like a mirror right below my camera, so if you see me like leaning in, just know it's just me trying to look at what I'm doing. So before I even start to do my makeup, I make sure my skin is cleansed, toned, and hydrated and moisturized. So I already washed my face, already toned and hydrated, all that. But make sure you do that because it's good to make sure your skin is in check before you put any sort of makeup on it. So before I put any makeup on, I prep my skin with MAC Prep and Prime. This is their skin-based massage. Y'all, this stuff is amazing. I've been using this stuff since I was a junior in high school, and I can't see myself using anything else, honestly. I really hope they never discontinue this because it's amazing. They discontinued my favorite mascara and I'm still upset about that. So if they discontinue this, I have to fight someone at MAC. It's just gonna have to happen. So I love this primer because it has a bit of a shimmer to it. Now, when people hear that, they think it's gonna make their face glittery. Like my mom, when I told her that it has a bit of a shimmer, she thought it was gonna make her face look really like sparkly. It doesn't do that. I just think it helps give you a nice pre-glow. With primer, a little goes a long way, so I really do not need to use a lot. So I'm gonna put it here. As you can see, I also already did my eyebrows because doing my eyebrows alone takes almost 10 minutes and I don't want to spend that much time doing them. Okay, so once that's on, I'm going to take my Benefit Professional. This stuff is pretty nice too. I've been using this for a while too, and with this, a little goes a long way because I only put it on like the bridge of my nose, and so I've had this for a while, I won't lie, but it shouldn't expire, right? Yeah, it should be fine. Fine. I'm gonna put that on the bridge of my nose here. Really oily skin, so my pores are a lot more visible, and so this stuff helps to, you know, conceal it as much as possible. So next, I'm gonna take this stipple brush that I got from e.l.f. It was really cheap. I'm pretty sure a lot of you already know e.l.f. brushes are super cheap. Okay, so once that's good, I just like to use that because I think it works the product into my skin better. Once I do that, I am now going to take, now this is what really helps me get a pre-glow. I'm going to take MAC Strobe Cream. This is a sample size because honestly, the full size, a little goes a long way with this product, so you don't really need a whole lot, and so it lasts you for a long time. If you want to get the full size, that's fine, but I feel like if you want to ball on the budget, just get this size. And then I take L'Oreal's True Match Lumi, and this is in, I forget what shade this is. There's like three different shades. This one is rose. Yes, this is rose. So I'm gonna take those. I'm going to, again, a little goes a long way. Put a little on my finger. I'm gonna put it on my cheekbones here and on my nose, the tip of my nose. I'm gonna take MAC Strobe. I'm actually running out. I need to go and buy more. Like, I'm squeezing the life out of this little thing. I'm gonna put in the same spot, my nose. you have like excess, just rub it on the back of your hand. And I'm going to rub it like that. Don't rub it in all the way though, because you'll see why. Just rub it in, and I like to put in the motion where I put my highlighter. So it's kind of like an outline of how I'm going to find everyone. Last but not least, I'm going to take MAC's Prep and Prime Fix Plus Spray. It looks just like that. It's essentially water, but of course it has like other stuff in it. But it's really just water-based. It says a soothing moisture mist that refreshes the skin and finishes makeup. Now, I do not finish my makeup with this because I feel like it doesn't help it in any sort of way. So I like to use it before I put my makeup on because it is a lot more effective. So I'm going to take my flat buffer brush and it's a buffer brush, right? Yeah. I'm going to work this into my skin. So I'm going to spray onto the brush and then I'm going to work into my skin. Once that's done, I have prepped my skin. My skin, you can probably already see now, it's a bit of a glow. It gives me a nice pre-glow. That's what I like to prep my skin with. You can see I prep my skin with a lot of MAC products. I like their Prep and Prime collection because it really does help to prep your skin and make it look ready to put makeup on. So once I do all of that, I'm going to curl my eyelashes. Now, I like to wear falsies. I recently found these amazing ones for like everyday wear because I used to do my eyelashes, but that was becoming pricey. It lasts for a while, but for me to keep going in just to redo them, I don't really have the time for all of that, so I just like to wear falsies. Now I am ready to put my makeup on. But I like to wait at least 5 minutes to put my makeup on once I prep it because I like to let the products I just put on my face sort of marinate a little bit. So I'm gonna wait 5 minutes and then I will put my makeup on. So now I can put my makeup on. I'm gonna start with Red Corrector. As you can see, I have disgusting looking dark under eye circles. I use the LA Girl Pro Conceal. Orange red. It looks more red to me, but maybe that's just my eyes. But it's the orange corrector. It's like an orange reddish sort of tone. This is all a part of being a human being. We all get dark under our circles, but it just makes me look more tired than I actually am. Well, I am tired, but I'm not that tired. So I conceal them before I use my concealer to further conceal them. So you probably notice me squeezing it. It comes with like the little applicator thing like that, which is really nice. It's like a little mini brush as a part of the product. And that's really nice because it makes it easier to apply it. And as you can see, I'm putting it on in like a triangle shape. Correct other parts of my face. So because I have warm undertones, you can probably notice like here, especially my T-zone, it's a lot more yellow than the rest of my face. Like the rest of my face is like darker, but then here it's yellow in my cheeks. So I have to put a little bit there just to help correct it. I'm gonna take this typical beauty blender and blend it in. Now, the trick to this is to have light fingers. You don't wanna like work it deep into your skin, just work it enough so that it's good there. Don't forget the eyelids because I sometimes forget those too. Once that is done, I'm going to take my concealers. So, quick little thing, I don't use foundation anymore because it just doesn't feel right on my skin. It always feels heavy. And a lot of people are like, oh, just look for a lightweight foundation. I've looked for lightweight foundations and they still feel heavy on my skin. I've just settled with using concealer. Another thing is that foundation is really good if you want like a certain amount of coverage. And I don't need a whole lot of coverage because like I don't really have that many blemishes. I'm not trying to stunt or anything. It's just I don't really have anything to cover up fully. I just like to have a nice even skin tone when I do my makeup. So I just use concealer, and this is concealer from ColourPop. It's their no filter concealer. I use two different shades because I like to brighten under my eyes and then just even out the rest of my face. So it helps for me to use, this is the shade Deep Dark 52. I like to use it under my eye, and then I like to use Deep Dark 58. Also Deep Dark 56, because that's really good for the summer. And I feel like 58 is really good for the winter. My skin tone just acts crazy that way. I feel like a lot of people's skin tone acts really crazy that way because you get more sun in the summer, you don't get as much in the winter, so they look completely different. So I'm gonna use Deep Dark 56 and 58 mixed together a little bit on my face to even out the rest of my face. I'm gonna take this one's 52, and I'm gonna put it under my eyes, forehead, cheek, and chin, and take 58. Just put it right on coverage. Okay. Boom. Now let's blend. I'm gonna take another beauty blender, and another thing is I wet my beauty blender. I feel like almost everyone wets their beauty blender because it helps to blend the makeup better. So I wet it a little bit, but don't drench it, you know, because you don't want to soak it. You just want it to be damp. With blending, y'all, it is so important that you blend your makeup, because I will go out and see some ladies. I'm not trying to hate on them or anything. Just I will see some ladies with here looking completely different from here, and it just doesn't make sense. So make sure you are blending your makeup all the way. Okay, so as I mentioned before, we don't want here looking different from here. So I'm gonna take a little bit more concealer. I'm just gonna take 58, Deep Dark 58. I'm just gonna put it here and here just to blend out on my neck. Literally blend until you feel like it looks like your skin. Like literally. Stop if you notice two-tone somewhere. Stop until it is looking like your skin. You see there. Some people do their eyebrows after they put concealer and stuff on, which I can understand because there are times I'll mess up my eyebrows when I'm putting concealer on, but I try to just work easily around that. Like I already told, I'm just gonna have to fix it a little. Now I'm gonna take my setting powder. I also use it from ColourPop. It's a no filter setting powder, but this one is medium deep. I have medium deep in yellow. Their setting powders are everything. Like, it's probably the best setting powder I've used. Besides, I used to use NYX HD Studio or something. Just know it had HD in it. And that setting powder was amazing, but the flashback was disrespectful. It was terrible. The flashback was just terrible, so I knew I needed to stop using it. I was looking like a whole ghost with flash on. So I also use translucent powder. This is really nice because I feel like it helps brighten some parts of my face. I'm trying not to spill it all over me because it does that. The thing with ColourPop is that it's so tiny, but it still comes out. There's a lot of product in here for the size, so don't be fooled by the size. There's plenty of product. It's been lasting me for a while now. I'm gonna use ColourPop's under my eyes and a little bit on like my nose because I get really oily there. And I'm gonna use Laura Mercier for the rest of my face, so we're gonna do that. Now with putting setting powder under my eye, I know some people like to let it sit under their eye. Like they put a bunch and they just let it sit to bake. I actually like to work it into my skin. Letting it sit and bake wasn't doing anything for me, so I'm gonna work it in. Just like that. Y'all see that? Just like that. So. And you can already see, like, it gives an amazing brightening power. Did y'all see that? Love it. I love it. Take Laura's powder and then put it and the rest of my face. I'm just gonna clean up my brows a little bit before I highlight those. I like bold brows, like filled in, like fully filled in, just because I like the way it looks with me better. I know that there's that whole, like, it kind of looks like an ombre, sort of, like where it's light, and dark. There's that, but I don't really like the way those look when I do them, so. So I'm gonna clean them up further, but I use NYX Tamer Frame, by the way. It's a tinted brow pomade. I use it in black. And I like using pomade for my brows because I just feel like it stays better as compared to like eyebrow pencil or what else do they have these days? They have like the tinted stuff, like it's like the tint, the eyebrow tint where you just swipe it on and then boom. I feel like those don't really do anything for me, so I like to use pomade. So now I'm going to use Fenty Beauty's Match Sticks in Rum. It's just like this, you know. Boom. And this is Rum. It's like a nice bronze sort of color. And I like to use that to highlight my brows. So I'm going to do that. Now this is what also helps me get really nice glow. Put it there right at the end of my brows. And then I'm going to blend it. So I like to use... It's like a really flat sort of eyeshadow brush, so I like to use that, and I'm just gonna work it in, also shape my brows further with it. Love it. But I literally love this one because it's just, it works so perfectly right there. You can also use matchsticks. I know some people use it for eyeshadow. I've used it for eyeshadow a few times. Some people use it for like highlighter. The only thing is that I just don't like the idea of having to rub it on. So I don't really use it for highlighter. But I do use it for eyeshadow sometimes when I just want a quick swipe of this to give it a bit of a shimmer. They also have in other shades that could work for concealers. I know some people use it for concealer. So you can use matchsticks for everything. So I would highly recommend getting these if you don't have them already. Yeah, I think they look good. They're gonna have to look good because I'm slowly running out of time. Whenever I go hang out with friends, I'm always the late one because I underestimate how long I'm gonna take to get ready. I'll be like, oh, I'm gonna only take an hour. And then I'm taking like an hour and a half, almost 2 hours just to get out of the house. So I think they look good. That's how I highlight my brows and a bit of a glow there. So now I'm going to actually put my eyeshadow primer. I use Urban Decay's eyeshadow primer potion. I feel like everyone uses this stuff because it is pretty amazing. I get really oily lids, so I'm just gonna apply it there. I'm just gonna take a Q-tip and just rub it all in. I'm gonna be using a few palettes. I always use like a bunch of palettes at once. So I'm gonna use Solar Flare from BH Cosmetics. It's a really nice palette if you like shimmer. It's a big eyeshadow palette, so it's literally all shimmer. Looks just like that. I love it. It's really nice. I think BH Cosmetics makes really good palettes for certain aesthetics. So they have this one, and they have like, I think they have a Zodiac palette. A lot of makeup brands are actually doing that these days. So I feel like everyone's into astrology. And I'm gonna use Royal Affair from BH Cosmetics as well. You can tell I really like BH Cosmetics. It's cheap. Like, you don't need to spend a whole lot of money on makeup, honestly. And not only that, they're a vegan brand and they're cruelty-free, so you should definitely check them out if you have never heard of them. Then I'm gonna use ColourPop's I Think I Love You. I really like that name, honestly. And I'm gonna use Naked 3 from Urban Decay. The basic bitch that I am. I'm gonna start by putting a base color. I typically use a color that's very close to my skin tone, so I'm gonna use, what shade is this? Screw It from ColourPop. It's the shade right here, that one. And so I'm just gonna put that on my lid just to give it a nice little face color. Okay, and then next, I have powder all over my robe and I just washed it, that's so crazy. Okay, so next I'm gonna use Majesty from Royal Affair. I really like the names in this too because there's like Majesty, Reign, Crown, Duchess, Monarch, Enchanted, like, imagine whoever came up with these names, you did some, because I really like that. So I'm gonna use Majesty, which is this color here. Let me try to show y'all how these look. It's that color right there. I'm gonna use that just to put here. It's a little lighter than Screw It, so I'm gonna put that right there. It would help to know what I'm wearing before I do all this, because I like to put eyeshadow on based on what I'm either wearing or what kind of jewelry I wear. And I'm most likely gonna wear gold jewelry, so we're just gonna work with it. I'm just gonna wing it, to be honest with you. I'm gonna take this palette from BH Cosmetics as well. This is a 99 color eyeshadow palette I got from them, and I got it on sale. And it looks like this. It literally has 99 colors, which is amazing. The only color it doesn't have is red, and I need a palette with red because I love red. I use this pinkish color right here. It's like that. It's like a little rosy. It's like a light pink. I'm gonna use that because I'm either gonna wear red or probably pink. That helps me just get ready to put the shimmer eyeshadow I'm about to use on. Solar Flare looks like this. Again, just like that. And then I'm gonna mix Burst and Galactic. Love that. Galactic is this one. And then Burst is right here. So I'm gonna use those and try to do a little sun. And then I'm gonna use, to get a little more shimmer, I'm gonna use Ozone. It's this color right here. Can you see that? Can y'all see that? That's Ozone. I like this one because it's literally all shimmer. It's like a sort of like a bronze. So I'm gonna use a little bit of that. Putting eyeshadow right there helps to bring it out a lot more. And I'm gonna mix a little bit of Gamma Ray. Gamma Ray is like a purple. I don't really use this a lot, but it's so pretty to me. It's just like that. I'm gonna use that too because I like the way it looks as well. So I'm gonna use some of that mixed in. So I'm just gonna use Impress and just get like here. I don't know what this area is called. I'm gonna get there. It's a little bit. Now I'm gonna, I think I like, yeah. Oh yeah, I got this little mini. If you go to MAC, you can get like two eyeshadows. Like, it's a double. I got this on sale one time. MAC was having like a little sale. You could get two for, I think it was two for like 10, or two for 15. I forget how much it was, but it was a pretty good deal because originally they were a lot more expensive. So I'm gonna take this one. I forget the shade names and they don't have them on there. So I'm gonna take this one and put it right here. Last but not least, I'm going to take Duchess and Royal Affair. It's like a darkish sort of brown. And I'm gonna put it right here as well. Now I'm going to, I love smoky eye look, so I'm gonna take Magnetic from Solar Flare. It looks like that. I'm gonna take that and I'm just gonna put it at the end here. This is like a blending brush, so I'm just gonna blend at the end there. You don't need a lot because you don't want to make it look like you have a black eye. You just want to have a bit of like an ombre type hue. I'm going to finish with Urban Decay's Naked 3, and I'm going to use Black Heart, which is right here at the end, and do the exact same thing. What I like about this one though is that it has more of a shimmer than Magnetic. Light fingers because you don't eyeshadow is done. Now I gotta do lashes, which doesn't take a lot of time. Before, it used to take a lot of time for me to do lashes, but now it's pretty easy for me. So before I do lashes though, I'm going to use my finishing powder in Deep, number 5. This is a nice finishing powder because it also has shimmer. As you can see, I love shimmery type of makeup, so this is really nice. I just put a little bit, don't need a lot at all. There's a lot of product, like this stuff has been lasting me for at least 4 years now, I think. Does finishing powder expire? Does anyone know? You let me know if it does, because I've been using this stuff. I mean, my skin is still fine, like nothing's happened, but just let me know. I'm going to start with, you know, the process of doing my lashes, which is a process. And I'm gonna use these lashes from Andrea. It's Andrea 5 of a Kind, and it is the natural one. They have dramatic ones, natural ones, volumized ones, all kinds. And I really like these lashes because I've been looking for lashes that are a lot more natural. Look, I have dramatic lashes, which are great for like events that require them, I feel like. But with these, you can wear them anywhere, anytime. And applying lashes, if you're someone who struggles, it's really helpful to use tweezers or one of those like lash. I have one of those lash applicators, but I feel like they're harder to use as compared to tweezers, so I just use regular tweezers. Some people just use their hands. Sometimes I do that. If that works for you, then just do that. We're gonna start with eyeliner because you want to make it look like it's your lashes, and eyeliner helps you do that. I just use Ultra Ink Liner from Kat Von D. I just got this in the essentials kit that I received from her campus. I like it because it goes on very simple. It's a flexible felt tip, so it's very easy to apply, so I'm gonna do that. Okay, so once your eyeliner is on, you can now start putting your eyelashes on. So let's get right into it. And I'm gonna do my bottom lashes. I use Mary Kay's Lash Love Mascara. Like I said, MAC discontinued my favorite, so I had to switch this. But you like, I'm not even mad. Not even mad about it. Put that on the bottom lashes. Helps to look down like this. Like everyone has a lash. They're putting their like lashes or their mascara on. Everyone has like a face when they do this. With bottom, I like something that makes them look longer. Not so much a volume, but just like length, so that's good. And okay, now we're gonna put these lashes on. So I'm gonna take it and tweezers, put the glue. Also make sure I put some on the end, because see, putting them on is not the issue, it's just the ends can give me so much trouble. So make sure I have enough on the ends there. You want it to dry a little bit so it can go on easily. I think it's good to put on now. So the trick with lashes is look down. Don't try to like look at the mirror. So I'm gonna tilt my mirror down. There have been times where I put lashes on and my god, I struggle for a long time. Let that dry out of the way and we'll curl them, but you gotta let them dry. I'm gonna do the other ones and pray that the other ones go on easily as well. Just put it all over. What is wrong with me? So if you're also me and you got butterfingers, then you'll probably end up putting it all over the lash and just clean it off before it dries. Okay, and then let that dry all the way as well, because if you curl and it comes off, then just forget about them, honey, because it's not worth stressing over them. While I let them dry, I'm gonna put my highlighter on. So I like to use, I feel like everyone loves to use this as well, Trophy Wife, Fenty Beauty. Just like that. It's this one. There's one that I really, really want to try for you. It's called, I think it's, I forget what it's called, but it looked really nice too. But Trophy Wife is really nice. The thing with Trophy Wife is it's very pigmented, so you don't need a lot at all. It's gonna look like you have stripes of glitter on your face. So dip it in, light fingers, and right on the cheekbones. Yes. We love to see it. Then on the tip of my nose, I like to use MAC's Gold Deposit. It's just their mineralized skin finish. I just use this little brush here and just put it on the bridge of my nose. Not a lot, just enough to have it in there. So now I'm just gonna curl my lashes. So I'm gonna do this one because I'm pretty sure this one is more attractive than the other one. Ooh, love it. Y'all see that? They look so natural and they feel so light, so it doesn't feel like anything is on my lashes. Dramatic lashes, they feel a lot more heavy, especially mink lashes. Those are heavy, but these ones, great. And I'm just gonna put one coat of mascara. I'm gonna use Kat Von D's Go Big or Go Home. This is really nice mascara to volumize. We're basically done. That's literally how I get ready. That's really how I achieve nice, glowy, dewy, shimmery looking skin. With lips, I really just use lip gloss. I'll use a dark lippy for certain occasions, not all the time, but I'm gonna use NYX Lingerie to put on before I put my lip gloss. Pink type of color. For some people it's called nude, but it's not my type of nude. It's really just pink for me. Lip gloss from ColourPop. It's just the ultra glossy lip. This is champagne. I actually need to get more because I'm running out. And just put somewhat. I'm ready to go. So yeah, that's just how I get ready. I do my makeup almost every day. I'm going out, so I do. If I want to change something up, I'll change something up. I'm about to go and hang out with my friends, Jazz and Louisa. I'm meeting up with them again in Philly. I haven't seen them this entire summer, and the crazy thing is Jazz literally lives just an hour away from me, and then Louisa lives like 45 minutes away from Jazz, so she's gonna go pick her up, and then we're gonna meet in the city, we're gonna hang out, and you guys will be able to see a little bit of that. So keep watching this video to see where we go, what we do, where we eat, because that was my main concern. I just need to make sure I eat something. Keep on watching for that. Can't wait for you guys to meet them. I need to go now, so bye-bye. Hey y'all, I just wanted to show you what I decided to wear. I'm gonna be wearing this purple tube top and these pants. Fun fact, these are actually pajama pants, but don't tell anyone. And just white Air Forces, cause we're gonna be walking, I need to be comfortable. And I accessorized with some earrings, some rings. I'm gonna be having a little handbag with me, so yeah. Let's go meet up with Jazz and Louisa.
Gotta move in, Jazz.
Okay, we're making an appearance. We're all making an appearance. So this is Jazz, and this is Louisa. Y'all see the hair, right? The hair? Popped out. They both popped out. But we're here at Magic Gardens. I'm gonna flip it now.
At Magic Gardens. It's like a little art exhibit place. It's really nice. It's like a lot of glass.
Love to see it. Beautiful.
Right?
But we're here now, and we're gonna go where? Jazz, where are we going?
Condom Kingdom.
Can't film in there, though.
Did y'all hear that?
Yeah.
She said Condom Kingdom. Louisa.
It's a place.
Why aren't you giving me more information?
It's a place you go inside of.
I need more information. For
a name like that. You'll get the information when you go there. It's indoors, it's air conditioning.
Yeah.
For a name like that, I need more information.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
That's crazy.
That's all you need to know.
That is crazy. I'm not getting nothing else. That's it.
That's it.
Blasphemy. Okay, well, we'll go there. We'll go there and we'll see.
Look who's here. We got Louisa. We got Jazz. Half the food, Louisa.